So this morning, I received a special delivery at the front office. It's a brand new class set of coloured pencils. I know, exciting, right? Now, the team at the front office were very clear that they needed to know the total number of pencils before I hand them out to students. They said that inside this box, there are 27 pencil cases, and in each pencil case, there are 14 coloured pencils. Now, I could open up all the pencil cases and count each pencil one by one, but that would take ages. So instead, I'm going to use my multiplication knowledge. I know that 27 equal groups of 14 is 27 times 14, but that's quite a big multiplication problem. Never fear, today I'm going to show you one of my favourite mathematical strategies called the area model, which is perfect for solving multiplication problems involving larger numbers. Now, the reason this strategy is called the area model is because we are going to take our multiplication problem, 27 times 14, and turn it into a rectangle. Then, we are going to find the area of that rectangle, because the process of finding the area of a rectangle actually involves multiplication. We multiply the length by the width. So, even though our problem is about coloured pencils in pencil cases, we can still use this strategy to find our answer. Pretty cool, right? Now, the first thing we need to do is draw a rectangle. The longer side of our rectangle is going to represent 27, and the shorter side is going to represent 14. Now, when you're using this strategy, it's also helpful to imagine your rectangle being split up into equal rows and columns. In our case, we would have 27 equal columns and 14 equal rows. Now, if we overlap these rows and columns, we end up with a grid or an array with lots of squares. Don't worry, I'm not expecting you to draw all these grid squares. Each of these squares represents one pencil in our whole class set, and if we were to go through and count up all these squares one by one, we would find the answer to our multiplication problem. But let's not do that. Instead, we're going to partition or split up our rectangle into smaller rectangles to give us four easier multiplication problems to solve. This is where we need to draw some lines, but only two. Toward the right-hand side of our rectangle, we are going to draw a vertical line from the top to the bottom. What we have done here is split our 27 into 20 and 7, so that this side of our line represents 20 equal columns, and this side represents 7 equal columns. Make sure to write 20 and 7 above each of these sections. Now, we're going to do the same thing with our 14, and draw a horizontal line toward the bottom of our rectangle. Now, this larger top section represents 10 equal rows, and this bottom section represents 4 equal rows. Write 10 and 4 next to each of these sections. We now have four smaller rectangular arrays, which makes the process of finding the total number of squares much easier. We simply have to multiply the length by the width of each one. Let's start with our biggest rectangle in the top left. It has a length of 20 and a width of 10, and 20 times 10 is 200. Let's write it down in this section. This rectangle in the top right has a length of 7 and a width of 10, and 7 times 10 is 70. Starting to see how easy this is? This rectangle in the bottom left has a length of 20 and a width of 4. 20 times 4 is 80. And this last rectangle in the bottom right has a length of 7 and a width of 4. And 7 times 4 is 28. Now, the last step is to add all these values together using whichever addition strategy suits you best. Therefore, the total area of our rectangle is 378 square units, and the answer to our original multiplication problem, 27 times 14, is 378 coloured pencils. Now, one thing to note about this strategy. When you're partitioning your rectangle into smaller sections, split it up in a way that works for you. In our previous example, we might have split our length up into 10, 10, and 7. Or maybe even 20, 5, and 2. This will just mean you have to add together a few more numbers during the final step, but if you've done everything correctly, you should still get the same answer. Now that we have a decent understanding of the area model for multiplication, it's time to test it out. Here's a couple of multiplication problems for you to tackle across three levels. Level 1. In this problem, you can only use the digits 1, 3, 5, and 7. Your task is to organize these digits to create a number sentence, a two-digit number multiplied by another two-digit number. For example, you might use the 3 and the 1 to make 31, and the 5 and the 7 to make 57. Then your number sentence would be 31 times 57. Now, the answer to this multiplication number sentence is a three-digit palindrome, 555. A palindrome is a number that reads the same forward and backwards. Alright, here's level 2. In this problem, you can only use the digits 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. Again, your task is to organize these digits into a number sentence. This time, however, we are looking for a two-digit number multiplied by another two-digit number minus a one-digit number. The answer to this number sentence is a four-digit palindrome, 2,222. And lastly, level 3, if you're feeling particularly ambitious. In this problem, you can only use the digits 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. This time, our number sentence is a two-digit number multiplied by another two-digit number multiplied by a one-digit number. The answer to this number sentence is a five-digit palindrome, 14,841. One important note, across all three levels of these problems, you can only use each digit once. We hope you enjoy using the area model to crack these formidable multiplication mysteries. Thanks for watching. We'll see you soon. Hey there! If you like what we do here at Teach Wonderful, make sure to subscribe to our channel. You'll also find plenty of amazing teaching ideas, student worksheets, and merch over at teachwonderful.com. Thanks for watching. We'll see you soon.